Well, hey everyone, it is Tuesday now. I just brought the processor out. You can see there's a wood pile down there. That's part of it. There's a little more to the left. I think Mark hauled 3 loads today. I gotta put a hose on the puncher. I blew a hose last. Well, it might have been easier to see it if I'd zoomed out. Well, it's a 3/4 inch, and those are number 12 flat faced fittings. I got a couple new O-rings to put on, but anyways, I'm gonna go put that on. I blew the hose last Friday, and it was later in the afternoon, so the place that we go get hoses made was closed, and I have a hose maker in my service trailer, and I just haven't stocked up on fittings for quite a while, so I didn't have the right fittings, and since the pandemic, whatever you want to call it, Traction, the place that we normally get our hoses made, isn't open on Saturdays. Always used to be. Wasn't really a big deal. I had a bunch of wood down, and so I've been processing this week, and I just finished a trail, and I'm gonna go put this hose on and finish cutting the end of it and bring that out. So hang on, I'll be back. Well, all right, we're back. I don't know. Put this hose down for you can see. Gonna lift some tools out there. But that hose hooks right to that steel line right there. I think maybe that guard's supposed to be up a little further so you can get in there with a wrench. But I just used a chisel to get that line undone. I'll probably do the same thing to tighten it up. And it just goes and hooks to that line right there. And put some new O-rings on it and make sure it doesn't leak. And off we go. Alrighty, we got it tightened up there. The hose runs right through here up over that cylinder. We got it tightened there. Here's my handy step stool. Thing's great. You can see it looks right there. Put the new O-ring in. Hopefully it doesn't leak. I never had a stool kicking around, but it's really nice to, it doesn't look that tall, but I can't reach those fittings up there at the end of that cylinder, the tilts or the head dump, and there's another fitting that hooks, that greases the pin up there for the tilt cylinder. Doesn't look that tall, but I can't reach it. I'm not super tall, but I'm 5'11", so I'm not real short either. Shows you how kind of tall that is. And we'll get in here and fire this up. Alright, it looks like we got the problem fixed. One-handed operating it. Try and get it out there far enough. But not leaking. Fitting's right up there. You can see a day or so before, or a couple days before it started leaking, you can see it was getting a little hydraulic leak. I thought it was something else leaking, but it was that hose getting ready to go. So my new hose has got it all cleaned up. Alright, well, don't touch that. Just brought the harvester. Yeah, what else can I call it that's not its name? The fella buncher out. I finished cutting that back section of this job, so I don't have to go back there, which was what I wanted to do Friday. But, whatever. Got her finished. Well, I thought I'd put this video together today, so if you want to like, subscribe, and comment, that'd be pretty cool. There's a pile of hardwood pulp. I think Mark did 3 today. And look how dusty the forwarder is. Wes left a buggy on. He didn't unload it. But, Mark did three today, and Wes pretty much filled back in whatever Mark hauled. And I think Wes did probably at least a buggy of firewood. So that's not too bad. We're not killing ourselves here. Three, four loads a day. I'm happy with that. The wood is really kind of cruddy, and I wished it was a little better. Let me clean you guys off. My camera's all nasty here. That's a little better. The wood is not great here, but it's a little more of a struggle with the buncher. Not as far as cutting it, but it's really when I notice when I'm running both pieces. If we were cutting this wood all the time, I'd have to seriously think about. I can still do it, so it's not unnecessary, but it would start to wear on you how much you had to work to stay ahead of the process of running both pieces. But I can deal with it for now. We don't usually cut wood like this all the time, but we have probably another. I probably have another couple days or so in the buncher here, and then. Then we're gonna move to our next job. We're gonna head north a little bit, and got a couple jobs. One's 20, which we wouldn't go that far just for that. The other one's 300 acres, so that'll be pretty nice. I'm hoping it's all wooded, or at least we get 100 or a couple hundred acres of decent wooded ground. That way we could kind of settle in and get a rhythm and produce for a while. I don't mind the drive. It's probably 45 minutes or so. And maybe if I get settled into a routine, I can trim this beard and stop looking like a homeless dub. So, like, subscribe, comment, and we'll catch you later.